list of content. Following list of content have been discussed as what is heavy metal, what is the route of exposure, uptake and bioaccumulation of heavy metals into humans. This has been explained by a flowchart diagram. Now, generation of free radicals as hydroxyl radicals by heavy metals causing potential toxicity. Mechanism of heavy metal toxicity. As heavy metal induced oxidative stress and oxidation of certain biological molecules. How heavy metals inactivate enzyme function. So the sources and poisoning of heavy metals, as certain heavy metals have been discussed, lead, arsenic, chromium, cobalt. Heavy metals. Now, what are the heavy metals? Heavy metals are naturally occurring elements that have a high atomic weight and a density at least 5 times greater than that of water. A toxic heavy metal is relatively dense metal or metallite that is noted for its potential toxicity. Heavy metal poisoning is the accumulation of heavy metals in toxic amounts and in soft tissue of body. Symptoms and physical findings associated with heavy metal poisoning vary according to metal accumulation into the body. Many of the heavy metals such as zinc, copper, chromium, iron and manganese are essential to body function in very small amounts. But if these metals accumulate in the body in concentration sufficient to cause poisoning, then serious damage may occur. The heavy metals most commonly associated with poisoning of humans are lead, mercury, arsenic and cadmium. In most ores, heavy metals such as arsenic, iron, lead, zinc, gold, nickel, silver and cobalt exist as sulfides, while others such as manganese, aluminum, selenium, gold and antimony exist as oxides. Certain heavy metals such as copper, iron and cobalt can exist both as a sulfide and oxide ore. Some sulfides may contain two or more heavy metals together, such as chalcopyrite, which contains both copper and iron. As in this flowchart diagram, how heavy metals enter into the human via the oral route. Heavy metals basically present in the environment. They are present in atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere. Although these heavy metals are present in the ecosystem, their exposure to human is through various anthropogenic, that is the man-made activities. As in the earth crust, these heavy metals are present in ores, which are recovered during mining activities as minerals. During these mining activities, as these heavy metals are released from the ores and scattered in open in the environment, or these heavy metals as shown in this flowchart enter into the soil, transported by air and water to the other areas. Furthermore, when these heavy metals are used in industries for various industrial purposes, some of these elements are released into the air during combustion or into the soil or water bodies as effluent. More so, the industrial products such as paint, cosmetics, pesticides, herbicides also serve as a source of heavy metal. Heavy metal may be transported through erosion runoff or acid rain to different locations on soil and water bodies. Heavy metal poisoning may occur as a result of industrial exposure, air or water pollution. As through water bodies, it enters into the seafood and fish, and through seafood and fish, it enters into the human, causing the toxicity. Heavy metal poisoning occur as a result of industrial exposure, food, medicines, improperly coated food containers, or the ingestion of lead-based paint. Certain heavy metals are known to generate free radicals, which may lead to oxidative stress and cause other cellular damage. Free radicals, hydroxyl oxide, hydrogen peroxide. The mechanism of free radical generation is specific to the type of heavy metal. Heavy metals also inhibit protein folding. This was first observed when heavy metals such as cadmium, lead, mercury and arsenate were shown to effectively interfere with the refolding of chemically denatured protein. It was also observed that when proteins misfolded in the presence of heavy metal, the misfolded protein could not be rescued in the presence of reduced glutathione or EDTA chelator. The order of heavy metal in terms of their efficacy in folding inhibition is mercury, then cadmium, then lead, and correlate with the stability of their monodentate complexes with imidazole, thiol, carboxylate group in protein. As manganese vapor diffuses across the lung membrane to central nervous system, causing the damage to central nervous system. Similarly, organic salts of manganese, which are lipid soluble, while inorganic salts, manganese salts, which are water soluble, and these water soluble inorganic salts are distributed in plasma for renal elimination. Arsenic is distributed in blood and accumulates in heart, lung, liver, kidney, muscle and neural tissue, and also in the skin, nails and hair, causing the toxicity. Similarly, these free radicals also damage the nucleic acid and lipids. How these free radicals damage the lipids, it has been shown in the next slide, as how this radical starts to damage the lipids, and lipid free radical is created. And these free radicals also damage the nucleic acid as the DNA damage. Steps of lipid oxidation. At the initiation stage, radical attacks lipid membrane to form radical lipid, as in the it has been seen in the first step of initiation. The radical lipid further propagates the formation of peroxide lipid radical by reacting with dioxygen molecule or with a lipid, as it was shown in the propagation. It has been shown in the propagation step. This reaction further promotes damage of the lipid molecule. At the termination stage, two radical lipid molecule or with the peroxide lipid radical reacts to form stable lipid molecule. The major aldehyde product of lipid peroxidation is melandialdehyde, and it serves as a marker for lipid peroxidation. Generally, proteins are not easily damaged by hydrogen peroxide and other simple oxidants unless transition metals are present. Thus, protein damaged are usually metal catalyzed and involve oxidative fission, loss of histidine residues, the formation of protein-centered alkyl, oxyl, and alkyl peroxyl radicals. Iron is a useful heavy metal in human body, as it is a constituent of certain biological molecules like hemoglobin and involved in various physiological activities. However, in its free state, iron is one of the heavy metals generally known to generate hydroxyl radical, as shown below, by Penton reaction. As in the first step, iron reacts with the oxide anion and convert iron plus 3 state to iron 2 state. Then again this iron plus 2 state as conversion into the ferric by the oxidant hydrogen peroxide and the formation of hydroxyl radical. Now this hydroxyl radical is very reactive radical. Now the net reaction summarized into the step 3. In addition to above reaction, the following reaction below can also occur. Hydroxyl radical is the most common free radical generated by the oxidation of iron. Hydroxyl is capable of reacting with biological molecules such as proteins, lipids and DNA damaging. When hydroxyl radical reacts with guanine, a nitrogenous base of nucleic acid, it leads to generation of 8-oxo-7-8-dihydro-20-deoxo-guanosine and 2,6-diamino-5-4-amido-4-hydroxypyrimidine. It damages the DNA bases. Now the copper and arsenic. Copper ions have been identified to participate in the formation of reactive oxygen species as cupric and cuprous, which can participate in oxidation and reduction reaction. The cupric in the presence of biological reductants such as glutathione or ascorbic acid can be reduced to cuprous ions, which is capable of catalyzing the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide to form hydroxyl radical via the Penton process, as conversion of cuprous into cupric form and the formation of hydroxyl radical. Then this hydroxyl radical which is formed is capable of reacting with several biomolecules. This copper is also capable of inducing DNA strand breaks and oxidation of bases, as different bases adenine, guanine, cytosine, thiamine and uracil via oxygen free radical. Arsenic have been shown to generate free radicals such as superoxide singlet oxygen having the single oxygen, single electron, nitric oxide, hydrogen peroxide, the peroxyl radical, dimethyl arsenic peroxyl radical, and also dimethyl arsenic radical. Chromium has been shown in vitro studies, that is a laboratory study, to generate free radical from hydrogen peroxide, and also in vivo, that is study within the body, able to show the detection of free radicals due to chromium in liver and blood of animals. Cobalt has been shown to generate superoxide anion from the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, as in this equation, superoxide anion generation generated from the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. Vanadium is a heavy metal that occurs in various oxidative states and has been shown to generate free radicals. In plasma, vanadium is rapidly reduced to vanadium 4 by NADPH, nicotine, adenine dinucleotide phosphate, and ascorbic acid antioxidant, which bind to plasma proteins for transportation. As conversion of NADPH to NADP plus, as removal of hydrogen, and vanadium plus 5 conversion to vanadium plus 4 state. This vanadium plus 4 further, in the presence of hydrogen peroxide, superoxide anion radical is generated. No more so under physiological conditions at approximately pH 7. Vanadium 4 can generate hydroxyl radical decomposition of hydrogen peroxide according to Fenton reaction as shown below. Generation of hydrogen radical takes place in this equation. Also, heavy metal toxicity may be induced by the replacement of metalloenzyme by another metal ion of a similar size. Cadmium can replace zinc in certain dehydrogenating enzyme, leading to cadmium toxicity. Such replacement can convert the enzyme to an inactive form and completely alter its reactivity. These heavy metals in their ionic species, such as lead, cadmium, mercury, arsenic, gold, form very stable biotoxic compounds with proteins and enzymes and are difficult to be dissociated. Heavy metal bound proteins may be a substrate for certain enzymes. In such situation, the heavy metals bound proteins fit into an enzyme in highly specific pattern until it is freed. As such, the product of substrate is not formed as the enzyme is blocked, and therefore heavy metals remains embedded in the tissue, leading to dysfunction, abnormalities and damages in the body. As inhibition of thiol transferase lead to increased oxidative stress and cell damage. For example, toxic arsenic present in fungicide, herbicide, insecticide can attack thiol sulfur group in the enzyme to inhibit their catalytic activity as shown in figure. The enzyme attached to the thiol sulfur group and this arsenic, that is the heavy metal, they together formation of product that lead towards the toxic effect as inhibiting the catalytic activities of the enzyme. Heavy metal poisoning basically the result of toxic accumulation of certain metals. Such metals compete with and replace certain essential minerals in the course of which any of several of the body organ system may be affected. Arsenic poisoning may be caused by medication including polar solution, potassium arsenite, and some topical cream that is used in the treatment of some skin contain arsenic. Arsenic is used in the manufacture of pesticide, ingestion of herbicide, insecticide, pesticide, fungicide, rodenticide containing arsenic may cause arsenic poisoning. Occupational exposure to arsenic in the manufacture of paints, enamel, glass, metals may cause arsenic poisoning. Other forms of occupational exposure include galvanizing, etching, lead plating, smelting, and wood preserving. Arsenic is also found in contaminated water, seafood, and algae. Chromium is used in the manufacture of cars, glass, pottery. Manganese is used as a purifying agent in the production of several metals. lead production workers, battery plant workers, welders and soldiers may overexpose to lead if proper precautions are not taken. Lead is stored in the bone but may affect any organ system. Mercury is used by dental assistant and hygienist and chemical workers. Now, the cadmium poisoning that may be caused by injection of food, grain, cereals and leafy vegetables and cigarette smoke, over occupational exposure to cadmium in metal plating, battery and plastic industries may also occur. There are multiple industrial, domestic, agricultural, medical and technological applications have led to worldwide distribution in the environment, raising concerns over their potential effects on the human health and the environment. The toxicity depends on several factors including dose, route of exposure, chemical species as well as the age, gender, genetics and nutritional status of exposed individuals. Because of their high degree of toxicity, arsenic, cadmium, chromium, lead, mercury rank among the priority of metals that are of public health significance. These metallic elements are considered systematic toxicants that are known to induce multiple organ damage even at low level of exposure. These are classified as human carcinogens, known or probable carcinogen, according to US Environmental Protection Agency and International Agency for Research on Cancer. There are two types of the poisoning: acute poisoning, either chronic poisoning. Now, what happened to acute poisoning? This happens if you get a high dose at one time, like in a chemical accident, in a factory, or after a child swallows a toy made with lead. Symptoms usually come on quickly and you may feel confused, feel sick, and volunteer may pass out. Acute poisoning basically is an emergency. Chronic poisoning means you get this after contact with low dose over a longer period of time. As the metal builds up in your body, you can get sick. Symptoms come on slowly and can include headache, weakness, tiredness, itchy joints and muscles, and many others. Overexposure due to arsenic may cause headache, rosiness, confusion, and life-threatening complications. Neurological symptoms include brain damage, encephalopathy, nerve disease, as peripheral neuropathy. Skin problems include transverse white bands on the fingernails, which is known as Mees lines, and excessive accumulation of fluid in the soft layers of tissue below the skin, known as edema. Gastrointestinal symptoms include a flu-like illness, gastroenteritis, that is characterized by vomiting, abdominal pain, fever and diarrhea, which in some cases may be bloody. Other symptoms include breakdown of hemoglobin of red blood cells, that is known as hemolysis. Hemolysis means breakdown of red blood cells of hemoglobin. A low level of iron in the red blood cells, known as anemia, and low blood pressure, that is known as hypotension. Some individuals may experience a garlic-like odor that may be detectable on the breath. The onset of symptoms in chronic arsenic poisoning is about 2 to 8 weeks after exposure. Skin and nail symptoms include hardened patches of skin, which is known as hyperkeratosis, which usually deep creases on palms of the hands and soles of the feet, usually darkening of certain areas of skin. Chromium poisoning: exposure to too much chromium may cause lung and respiratory tract cancer as well as kidney disease. In addition, overexposure to chromium may also cause gastrointestinal symptoms such as diarrhea, vomiting, often with blood. Symptoms may lead to severe water electrolyte disorders, increased mild acidity of blood and body tissue, acidosis. or inadequate blood flow to its tissue resulting in shock. Lead poisoning. The effects of lead poisoning varies depending on the age of individual and the amount of exposure. In children, symptoms vary depending upon the degree of exposure to lead. Some affected individuals may not have any noticeable symptoms. Symptoms usually develop over 3 to 6 weeks time period. Lead overexposure may cause children to irritable and sluggish. In some cases, symptoms include headache, vomiting, abdominal pain, lack of appetite, which is known as anorexia, slurred speech, changes in kidney function, usually high amount of protein in the blood, which is known as hyperproteinemia, and usually pale skin resulting from a low level of iron in the red blood cells, that is known as anemia. Thallium poisoning. Symptoms associated with thallium poisoning include extreme rosiness, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and bloody vomiting, that is known as hematemesis. Cobalt is used in making jet engine may cause nausea, vomiting, anorexia, nerve damage, respiratory disease, as unusually large thyroid gland known as goiter, or heart or kidney damage. Manganese poisoning. Symptoms associated with overexposure to manganese may include damage to central nervous system, pneumonia. Additional symptoms and physical findings include weakness, fatigue, confusion, muscle spasms, stiffness, tremors of hands. Mercury poisoning. Mercury can affect lung, kidney, brain, or skin. Symptoms of mercury poisoning include fatigue, depression, irritability, and headache. Respiratory system symptoms associated with inhalation to mercury vapors include coughing, breathlessness, burning pain in chest, respiratory distress. Some affected individual may experience abnormal buildup of fluid in the lung, pulmonary edema caused pneumonia, or abnormal function of fibrous tissue, that is known as fibrosis. Phosphorus poisoning. Symptoms associated with phosphorus poisoning include weakness, headache, vomiting, abnormal cramps, dropping of the upper eyelid, ptosis, contraction of pupil, miosis, or muscular weakness and twitching. Exposure of heavy metals to humans involves serious diverse forms to food and water consumption. Inhalation of polluted air, skin contact, and most important by occupational exposure at workplace. Through some heavy metals such as iron and manganese are essential for certain biochemical and physiological activities in the body. Elevated level in the body can have negative health effects. Most of the other heavy metals are generally toxic to body at very low level. The main mechanism of heavy metal toxicity includes generation of free radicals to cause oxidative stress, damage of biological molecules such as enzymes, proteins, lipids, and nucleic acids, damage of DNA, which is key to carcinogenesis, as well as neurotoxicity. Some of the heavy metal toxicity could be acute, while others could be chronic after long-term exposure, which may lead to damage of several organs in the body, such as brain, lungs, liver, and kidneys, causing certain disease in the body.